Speaker, last week the Parliamentary Secretary admitted that Veterans Affairs sent $1.13 billion back to the Treasury instead of spending it on veterans. This weekend, the Minister contradicted his Parliamentary Secretary, saying the money is recycled into veterans programs. But all we ever see are self-serving TV ads. Now facing a mounting backlash, and on the eve of the Auditor General's report, the Conservatives announced inadequate funding for vets and their families, a fraction of the $1.13 billion. Right. So can the Minister tell us now, of this $200 million announcement, how much do they plan to lapse?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary, the Minister of Veterans Affairs.
Mr. Speaker, the assertion made in that question is absolutely false, Mr. Speaker. All governments always ensure statutory funding is fully funded to ensure there is no shortfall. This is a completely normal practice. As a proof, in the last year of the Liberal government, Veterans Affairs lapsed $111 million, Mr. Speaker. $111 million in 1 year under a much, much smaller budget, Mr. Speaker. Simple fact, when Veterans Affairs expenditures have increased under our government, that party voted against it.
The Honourable Member for Guelph.
Mr. Speaker, do you know what they could have done with that $1 billion? They could have easily kept all of the 9 veterans' offices open. They could have hired enough caseworkers so that veterans don't have to wait to access services. In the face of 160 military suicides in the last decade, they could have hired more mental health professionals.
Absolutely.
They could have provided the funds to ensure dignified funerals for all veterans. Now it's too little, too late. Why do they make veterans beg for the services they need and they deserve?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary.
Mr. Speaker, I think it's no secret Canadians still remember it was under the Liberal government that our men and women suffered a decade of darkness, Mr. Speaker. When it comes to standing up for Canada's veterans, men and women in uniform, our government has a strong record. Exactly why, Mr. Speaker, our government has spent over $30 billion since taking office. That's $5 billion in additional funding. Mr. Speaker, we will continue to stand up for Canada's veterans on this side of the House.